Hello and a very good afternoon. Thanks for joining us here on Urban TV. This is Family Unscripted. We come your way every other Sunday, 4 p.m. Yes, and there is a repeat. Now the repeat has changed. It shows on Wednesdays, 9 a.m. So make sure you don't miss out on what we discuss. If you miss, please make sure you catch the repeat. So we are back again. Thank you for joining us from everywhere you are around the country and, of course, all over Africa. And who knows, we might be as well outside Africa. Thank you so very much for making us your number one station. And once again, it is Family Unscripted. We look at what's happening. The kids are getting holidays. Our children are getting holidays. I think it started with this weekend, and then it's going to go on for a bit until they get their holidays fully. But they don't just come back home. They come loaded. Holiday packages. Yes. I totally agree with you. I know what you're doing right now. Probably thinking, yes, our kids are always tired. Yeah. So they're coming with holiday package. And of course, we cannot say no. This is school. This is everything. We have to find a way. So with me in the studio today is a gentleman and a lady with whom I'm going to interact with and try to understand, really, what are holidays for? I'll begin with a gentleman. Welcome to the show, Sebo.
Thank you very much.
Your name and your designation.
My name is Mukasa Patrick, and I'm a teacher. I run schools.
What do you mean you run schools?
I'm a teacher who runs schools. I'm a director of schools.
Ah, yeah. That's okay.
I'm the director of Machinde Junior School. Mm-hmm. I'm the director of Victoria Mutundwe.
Right.
And I also run a company called Prime Educational Consult.
Wow. Wow, amazing. So I have an educationist with me here. That's amazing. You guys are going to tell us why you give our kids a lot of homework. So I have the lady with me here. You're very much welcome to the show.
Thank you very much, Lynn.
Your name and your designation?
I'm called Kodra Christine. I am a director at Quality International Nursery and Elementary School, which is located in Chanja.
Wow, amazing. Thank you for making time to come and join us here on the show. Now, You're a director of a number of schools, and you also have a consulting company. Why do you give our kids a lot of homework?
Why do we give kids a lot of homework?
For holiday. We can understand during the term, but holidays.
Yeah, I think the key word in your question is a lot.
Yes.
A lot.
Yes.
I don't think children should be given a lot of homework, a lot of holiday work. They should be given enough holiday work to keep them attached to academics, so that they don't forget what they've been learning, so that the parent can interact with them as they are writing it, so that the neighbor, the friend, the nephew, the brother, the cousin can work with them.
Yeah.
Was so that the holiday work or the homework is a platform for them to interact. It should just be enough, not too much. If it's too much, then it becomes a chore. It becomes a lot of work to do. It becomes something to substitute what should be done during holidays.
Wow.
So a lot of homework, a lot of holiday package. I don't agree with that.
This is what we get. This is what our kids come home with.
Probably because some teachers need guidance on why they give holiday work. I think many teachers give holiday work without thinking much about why they are giving it.
Right.
Without thinking much about what is happening at home in the families. Who is going to write this holiday work? Who are at home? What are the activities at home?
Yes.
What's the program at home? How does the child go through life at home? But if they do, I think they will have a better why, and therefore better holiday work.
Wow, that's very interesting. Kristen, at your school, do you give these kids holiday packages?
Yes, of course we do give holiday packages.
Why do you give them a lot of it?
Exactly. I will start by talking about your keyword, a lot. Now, we have this generation of parents who do not want to get in touch with their children's academics. So even when you give one page, they will quickly say a lot. And I think a lot is relative.
Okay.
It is really not a lot of work. Okay. It is enough work.
Okay.
Yes, we do give holiday package. And my one reasoning towards our giving holiday package is the world has revolved.
Right.
We are living in this dot-com era. There is too much TV, too much internet, too many phone games. A lot of activity goes on in these children's lives. So if we do not give holiday work, the children will be detached from academics. And by the time they return back to school, they are blank. They have all these cartoons filled in their heads. They have all these video games. Yeah. Everything is going on.
And
so
I
that's why we prefer to engage them with holiday packages.
Sure, sure. And I know parents who invest a lot in cartoons and PlayStation and all sorts of things for kids. Holidays here, okay, I need to buy ABCD. And their budget includes just cartoons.
And that is too much work for the children too.
So now it is our problem. Yeah. It becomes too much. This is why you guys decide to give us, to give the kids homework so that they can stay focused. Well, that is also relative. Because if you give a child, depending on the age, a lot of work, will they, when their minds really be clogged with work, school work all the time?
This work that we give the children, it is guided work. We give it in phases. Mm-hmm. You'll, for example, we have 3 weeks this holiday.
Yes.
You'll give a 3 weeks holiday package, mm-hmm. tagged week one, week two, week three. And we are looking at you doing at least 3 numbers per day.
Wow.
So some of these pupils, what happens is the duty of doing the holiday package is negated until the last moment of returning to school. So that's why the parents feel the pressure of a lot of work. What was programmed for 3 weeks, you are pressuring the child to do this work in 2 to 3 days before reporting back to school. So I think if the children tackle the work according to the instructions that are given to parents, this work that we give is not much. And it is really recommended that they do the holiday work.
With the dot-com era and social media, there's a group on Facebook. Some mothers were complaining that the kids are given a lot of homework. And it was posted on that page. Well, we all know it. It is Mama Tendo. They posted on Facebook and were complaining, our kids get a lot of homework. They don't have time to visit their parents. They don't have time to, visit their relatives, interact with other kids. And I'm thinking, so who is to blame? Like, she highlighted that the parents, put the kids under pressure in the last minute. Now, with those complaints, why?
I think that means that homework or holiday package, whatever one wants to call it, is giving people an opportunity to program themselves. It's an opportunity. It is a task that is requiring people to program themselves, and therefore it's an opportunity to program when this will be done. Like Christine was saying, If people went doing it daily, the 3 numbers, the 4 numbers, that's around 30 minutes. Now, these are 30 minutes of interaction between the parent and the young child. These are 30 minutes where where the parent is getting an opportunity to know what this learner is consuming in the mind. It's important that parents also care to know what learners are learning at school, what the curriculum is putting into their learners. So that's the only opportunity I see. Otherwise, there is a lot of time. For example, a day is 24 hours.
Yeah.
If you gave 30 minutes or an hour for homework, be it in the morning or in the afternoon. Then you can visit the friends later, you can go to church, you can do whatever you want to do. But this is an opportunity for the parent to interact with the young mind.
Yes.
This is an opportunity for the parent to learn what the teachers are teaching your child.
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. Christian, do you encounter moments when children come back to school and they have literally lost track?
Yes, we do get these children, despite the fact that we give holiday packages.
Mm-hmm.
Like you highlighted earlier about this trend of the new breed of mothers, like
yes.
the ones on Mama Tendo. They have a lot of time for social media.
Yes.
And less time for their little ones. They have left even this holiday work thing to the house helps. So they even don't know what happens in the holiday package. So sometimes when you employ someone who does not know or doesn't care to follow up on the academics or help your child to do the work, and the child has been doing all these cartoons, PlayStation and whatever all through the holiday, by the end of 1 month, the child has
lost
it. Yeah. And he's trying to do the holiday work, it's not moving. They will come back with it, it's half done. And when they get to class, usually the first week of orientation is a hard paper for us in school, because we have to literally go back and do the last term's whole catch up, because they have lost it. They have been pumping into their heads all sorts of things that are not too beneficial towards their academic progress.
And there are, I'm sure there are parents who, you know, run, take their kids back without
they prefer to post numbers on WhatsApp groups and say, dear parents, what do you think I should do about this? And they really do nothing about it and stop at chatting about it on all these social media platforms.
Wow, that's a very interesting one that we'll get into. We need to take a quick short break, and when we return, Christian, I think, has highlighted something very interesting. These, you know, trendy mothers, slay queens and slay judges. We'll be right back.